Universal design principles are essentially a set of guidelines that help developers create accessibility features in the design of their products. Examples of this can be as simple as the inclusion of closed captions on videos, or as complex as the recent changes in HTML5 that are designed around allowing websites to be navigated in multiple ways using assistive technology. One aspect of the second principle of universal design is that information be presented in multiple and often simultaneous ways. This is referred to as multimodal learning. In a nutshell, multimodal learning is the belief that when multiple learning modes are effectively used together, the learner will gain a better understanding of the concept. So, what is a mode? Anything that communicates meaning. Take the word stop, for example. The word itself represents a concept, but not really the context. Add color, and the meaning suddenly becomes deeper, but add shape, and now we have a stop sign. But what if you're colorblind? What if you don't know the language, or the visibility is low? Even when one of these modes are missing or inaccessible, the meaning of the stop sign can still be communicated. This is the nature of multimodal learning. Different modes work together to create meaning, with each mode contributing to that meaning in a unique way.
But is this an effective way to communicate?
Probably not. Effective multimodal communication works best when words and pictures are presented simultaneously and in close proximity, but also when extraneous words and images are removed. Animation and narration work better than animation and text, and well-designed layouts are shown extra effective when working with learners with low knowledge or with high spatial learning abilities. Research shows that multimodal videos are effective at improving student performance for both basic and advanced skills, as well as in interactive and non-interactive environments, but they are most effective when used to present complex material in an interactive environment. So, how does multimodal learning work with the principles of universal design? Let's say you have a concept you'd like to teach. You know the disabilities of some of your learners, but it's a pretty safe assumption that you don't know all of their disabilities. So you start by explaining the concept in multiple ways. You use text and images together. This can really help students who may not be able to hear you or understand what you're saying to still make sense of the meaning. You add audio for those who learn best through listening or may not be able to see well. You add animation to that audio to focus attention. And by animation, I mean anything that moves on screen. And you add closed captions to all the audio. YouTube offers an easy way to do this. Once you are finished, test your video. Turn off the sound and see if it makes sense. Listen to the audio without any images. Does it still make sense? Show it to someone unfamiliar with the concepts. Does it make sense to them? Remember, the core of multimodal learning is communicating your concept in the most effective way possible. And the core of universal design is that everyone, regardless of limitation, will be able to access that communication. Learning to communicate in this way will require practice, and it will involve a lot of trial and error. But the better you get at it, the easier it will become. And once you start to see the benefits of these strategies, it will all become worth it.